Hey guys, hello and welcome to Mat. So in this video, I will show you how to blend color tones using Infinite Painter. Before that, let me create my canvas. I will use a screen size template. You can take any one of it as Painter has many options. Number 1. By default, the canvas color is white. I will change it to black. Let me take a circle shape. You will get it in the tool section. Now picking the color, I am taking solid pen to draw the outline. In between the circle, I will blend the colors. The first method is shading. Firstly, I will fill the circle with the darkest shade. You can use a soft or medium airbrush for shading. I am taking soft airbrush. Take the lighter color and start shading. Take the brush opacity to 40 to 50% for better control of your brush. So you can see, I start from the darker shade of a color and gradually I am going to the lighter shade. Although I will show you 4 different methods, but this will follow in everywhere. This is my first way to blend colors. I will show 4 different ways of blending using Infinite Painter. Number 2 is blending. I have already taken 5 different colors. So Painter offers a brush named Colorless Blender for blending purpose. Blend the conjugate portion of 2 different colors. Number 3. Smudging. This is smudge tool. Tap on it and choose your smudging brush. Well, now I am taking medium size airbrush. You can take the hard or soft airbrush also. Adjust the size of the brush. Blend the conjugate portion of 2 different shades. I am taking the darker shade first and then gradually I will go to the lightest shade of the color. I would like to suggest one thing, that you should always assume the direction of your light source. I mean, from where the light is coming from in your picture. Although this video is about how to blend, but we should always try to be better. And this will help you drawing figures or portrait or any kind of realism. So the front side to where the light directly falls will be lighter shade and the exact opposite side will be the darkest one. Number 4. I am using medium airbrush for this method. Adjust your brush size, flow according to your choice. So in this method, I will pick the color from the conjugate portion where these two different colors meet. Then I apply the airbrush to the adjacent portion. So continue the same process until I will get the complete result. It is clearly shown that each method showing different outcomes. Let me know which one is your favorite method. So you can subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon for notification. Hope you enjoyed my video and if you find it worthy, please like the video, share it and hey, don't forget to comment about your experience on digital art. Thank you, stay healthy, see you in the next video.